Dee Dee Sharp, everybody. You know, just for a moment there, I thought it, when you were singing, "I Really Love You," you were talking to me, but I know your husband, Bill's in the, I know that, I mean, but I can, a man can hope, can he?
Yeah, well, you can hope, but.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Thank you, Cousin Chip.
It's spring water, but
it's spring water? It has vitamins in it?
It's got vitamin B3, vitamin B6, vitamin B12, and ginseng.
And ginseng. Just for that little extra kick.
So that's what I drink.
I drink hot dog water, so what do I drink? but how do you go from being a teenager into rocket stardom, and how did that start?
The thing about it is, I answered an ad.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's how it started. I was 13 years old, and the ad said, "A one that can sing and play piano well." So my mother had had a bad accident, and I was worried about how my mother was going to take care of us, how my dad was going to take care of us. And I told my grandmother, I said, "I got to get a job. I just got to get a job."
At 13?
Yeah. I was an energetic child. I told my mom, I got to get a job. So my grandmother, she was always encouraging me. You know, she, God rest her soul. She's always encouraged me. She said, "Well, you're going to do it. You're going to do it. You're going to do it." And I said, "Okay, I'm going to do it." So I circled the ad, and I asked my grandmother, I said, my mom was at work. I said, "Okay." She said, "Do you really want to do this?" I said, yeah, I'm going to do it. So I knew I could play piano. I was playing at the age of 8, 9, and I was always playing classics. So I didn't know how to play anything but gospel.
Oh, wow.
"Jesus, keep me near the cross. Hallelujah." and that's all I knew how to play. So I said, "I'm going to get this job." Well, this woman that put the ad in the paper was Clara Ward's sister.
Okay.
The famous singer,
right.
Gospel singer,
famous
Clara
gospel
Ward.
Singer, sure.
She was one of the gospel singers for Clara Ward. And that was her sister. So she said, "Oh, my God, you sound such, you've got such tone and such good." I'm like, "Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am." So we started backgrounding Bobby Rydell,
yeah.
Chubby Checker, Frankie Cannon, Fabian. And I was doing all of this background stuff. Had no idea that February of 1962, someone was going to hand me a record and said, "Say, just sing it."
Mashed potato time.
Mashed potato time.
Let me tell you something. When I heard that song for the first time on the radio, I cried.
Really?
Mashed potatoes. I cried openly. And then when you followed it up with gravy, I went, "See how I hit? Gravy." I said, "I'm gonna grow up and marry this woman." On my radio. But Mashed Potato Time was huge, a million seller. It goes to the top of the charts. Mm-hmm. Now you're on the cavalcade. You go with Dick Clark, you're on the cavalcade. You're performing with all the legends. Mm-hmm. The list is immense.
To God be the glory.
And that happens, and then it goes. But what I love about you is not only your performing skills, which you had in the 60s and with the cavalcade, but then you get into the 70s, And you hang up with Kenny Gamble and Gamble and Huff, and you become part of the Philadelphia International Records, and then you go on to the management side, still dabbling in music, but you go on to the management side, the OJs, Teddy Pendergrass, Billy Paul, this woman, Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, this woman with the management that connected with Gamble and Huff made those groups. And I mean, not taking anything away from the talent of them, but it was the way you positioned them and got them out there because you had that experience of doing that.
I'm so grateful. First of all, I'm blessed of the Lord, okay? I pray hard. You have no idea how hard I pray. I pray for everybody, everything. I pray for everybody, but I prayed that those artists would do well. Because I knew that if they did well, it would shine well on my then husband. Mm-hmm. We've been divorced now. Kenny Gamble. God bless him. No, God bless him. I knew that it would shine back on us. And the thing about it was the OJs did not want to dress. They couldn't dress for squat. I took him to the clothing store and I said, now what kind of look would you like? And they was like, oh, flashy. I'm like, oh, no. You have to be classy. You've got to show some class. Now, Harold Melvin was different. Melvin would let me do whatever I wanted to. But Billy Paul, too. He let me do what I wanted to do. But the OJs were definitely a
project. They're a project. But that, I mean, I think that contributes so much to, and they talk about the Philly soul, the Philly soul and the Philly records and Philadelphia International Records down there. You're so in that. But you keep on transcending it. And many people don't know, you have a doctor in psychology.
Yes, I do.
From the University of Pennsylvania.
Clinical psychology, yeah.
Dr. Dee Dee Sharp. And let me ask you, how does that, you find time to do all this, and how does that work in blending in with the groups? I mean, you know what they're trying to pull, and you know everything else.
I know, been there, done that, and got a merit badge, okay? I look at people as people. Pray for them, but look at people as people. Some people are shoddy, some people are crazy, some people are nuts. Some people are just good folks. I mean, just good, honest people. When you look into a person's eyes, you can tell whether they're good, bad, or indifferent. I see you, and I see you, the kindness that you have in your heart,
Dee Dee,
okay?
Thank you.
I see
much.
The kindness you have in your heart.
That's beautiful. Well, you know, and I'm very flattered. It's such an honor to have you here tonight. You're in the Hall of Fame of Rhythm and Blues. So instrumental, and you had so many things. You were in the Dance Craze, you were in the everything, and to be here on the show, it means a lot to us, it means a lot to the band. And for updates, you can go to DeeDeeSharp.com.
DeeDeeSharp.com.
DeeDeeSharp.com will be on there, and I promise. And we'll be right back with more Dr. Dee Dee Sharp in the house tonight on the Big Joe Henry Variety Show. Don't go away.